Alright, hey guys. I unfortunately missed the actual live stream. I just got in. It's about 5:25 at this point, so I believe it is finished right now. It's on the YouTube channel, so I'm gonna watch from the beginning. So I skimmed a bit through it. It looks like the first 13 minutes is nothing but just saying state of play, so I'm gonna play it right here. I just got back from work. And sorry if I am sweating, because I ran all the way here. Why I didn't take the car, because I didn't want to pay.
Morning, sir. Our travel time to Shanghai is 11 hours, 15 minutes.
Told you we should have taken the faster flight.
I think the board prefers you wear a more conventional suit to these company meetings.
You can't outrun your past.
Is this supposed to be
in
VR?
Just imagine that.
Negative, sir. Sir, incoming!
A little late, don't you think? Friday, suit up, now!
Friday? Oh!
All systems online.
Iron Man, gotcha.
Sir, hostiles inbound, 10 o'clock.
So much for a hero's welcome. Any idea who we're up against?
You've made your share of enemies, sir. I'll need more time.
It kinda looks lame.
That's how it's done.
Threat neutralized.
Good. I have a plane to catch.
This is how you open it up, man? This is the first episode of the State of Play.
Welcome to State of Play.
All right.
A look ahead to the future of PlayStation. Throughout the year, State of Play will showcase upcoming games, updates, and announcements. And we've got plenty in store for our first episode, like the debut of Marvel's Iron Man VR, which is coming to PlayStation VR in 2019 from PlayStation's Worldwide Studios, developer Camouflage, and Marvel Games. Up next, a fan favorite announces extra goodies for PS4 players. Let's take a look.
No, what was on the side? It's like different images, so I was wondering what that was. Ooh! Yay, old school. Nope, I'm mostly in frame.
The popular kart racer is due out June 21st. Now, let's shift gears. Next up, the team at Hello Games beams us an update from the world of No Man's Sky.
Oh, more VR? You know what? No Man's Sky VR is a good idea, to be honest. Please tell me that it's just a mode for the game and not like you have to buy.
It's a match made in heaven. This summer, Hello Games plans to release No Man's Sky Beyond, a major update that adds, you guessed it,
okay, so it's
PlayStation
just an update.
VR
Good.
Support. And yep, the update will be free. Now let's get the world's first look at an upcoming game from PlayStation's Worldwide Studios and developer Robot Entertainment. You're seeing first gameplay of Ready Set Heroes. This is a fast-paced multiplayer dungeon crawler that packs a big twist.
Maybe they're just showing the lesser-known titles first, and then
launch into a randomly chosen dungeon to slay monsters, dodge traps, and collect mountains of loot. Now, here's the twist. You're actually competing against an opposing team who's racing through an identical dungeon. Reaching the end of the dungeon will trigger a winner-take-all arena brawl. The faster you progress through the dungeon, the more powerful you'll be when it's time to throw down. Ready Set Heroes had us hooked from the moment we picked up the controller. The combat feels crunchy and the loot flows like water. The final game is expected to support up to 4 players across online multiplayer and local split screen. Sounds like perfect party game material. Look for Ready Set Heroes to hit PS4 later this year. Next, let's get an update on the eagerly awaited PlayStation VR game first announced at Paris Games Week.
I don't think I heard about that one.
Marks. SAS Nomad Squadron. You're facing multiple life sentences.
Oh, that's the actor.
Conspiracy.
Colin Salmon, I believe?
More murders than we could even count. I just want to know what went down.
My name is Ryan Marks. I'm a soldier. Now, don't get me wrong, I love my day job. But it's always nice to come home. Spend some time with the family.
Mum!
Oh, for God's sake, what did I tell you?
See some culture.
Nice use of that Special Forces stealth there, mate.
Taking the sights.
Let's get inside, find out what he's hiding.
Catch up with some old friends.
Think of it as a merger. Apart from you, you can off back to the army.
Is that it?
I think I broke a window.
Tony's been approaching some of our people.
What are we looking for then? Clues, evidence, anything that tell us what Tony's up to.
Got it.
We need to push back
this,
hard on this.
This does look interesting.
Are you sure about this?
Get me under me! Closer! Closer!
Average weekend, really.
PlayStation VR heavyweight Blood and Truth finally has a confirmed release date, May 28th. That's just around the corner. In fact, PlayStation VR players have a lot to get excited about this year. Here's a look at the next wave of PlayStation VR titles slated for 2019.
More VR?
Turn the bass up. I wanna see you move.
This seems like it's the montage portion, so hopefully after this it's actual games. I'm not saying that these games aren't interesting, it's just... I kinda don't care about the VR games at this moment. Besides Blood and Truth, that looks really interesting. But my problem with VR games so far is that I don't like the illusion of the cut-off hands. It just looks weird to me. Like, everything looks so realistic. Then you see these Rayman-like hands, and I'm like, I can't get into that. Is it hard to, like, animate up to the arms, at least? That way, it looks like it's still part of you instead of the disembodied hands.
I'm a great human resource.
Is that Control?
Okay.
Devolver.
That's audio, at least. Almost there. Just a sec. There we go. Looking good, Sam.
From the creators of Stories Untold.
Give me a systems diagnostic. I need to know what is going on. I need the crew.
I know you're all afraid of what is happening. To the station. To us.
Captain.
And quite right, too.
You're not on the station.
I just want you to know.
You are the station?
Sam?
Sorry.
It's time. You have to take us there.
Observation. So is that like a Five Nights at Freddy's kind of game then?
Science fiction thriller Observation is coming soon to PS4, and it's bringing some serious development talent to its unusual and haunting premise. Our next game is a frightening new installment
in
a fan favorite series.
Oh my god! I honestly don't care about this. Am I supposed to be glad that this is coming on the PlayStation?
Here's some first footage. You'll try to survive different levels from the original games, as well as all new nightmares.
You're going in depth with this one?
Has picked up some unwanted friends. To clear the infestation, apply the Fazbear Entertainment rest.
I feel nothing.
Five Nights at Freddy's VR, Help Wanted, is the first virtual reality game in the Five Nights universe, and it's coming to PlayStation VR this spring. Next, let's get a new look at a gorgeous adventure coming soon to PS4.
Oh my god, after this, you only have two more. After this one, you have two more. Please show us something awesome! Okay, I'm liking this already.
Oh, what's this? Your little coloring book?
Oh, it's like stop motion. Oh, man, this. Oh, I'm loving the animations. Okay.
You're alive?
This looks really good.
Hey, over here.
You want me to do that? To paint this whole town back to life.
Are there gonna be like enemies or something like that? Are you all by yourself? Okay, I think this is gonna answer everything.
If I leave now, that darkness will just come back here.
Huh.
I can't let that happen.
It's like the never-ending story a little bit. Never-ending story with a bit of Epic Mickey. Concrete Genie. Open up with this! Open up with this! Damn! State of Play? PlayStation? Come on! Open up with that!
Concrete Genie is a creative new adventure from developer Pixel Opus. And today, we can also confirm the game will feature a PlayStation VR mode. More details to come as Concrete Genie prepares for launch later this year.
So far, I'm very excited for that one.
Up next, an update from the dangerous world of Days Gone.
Oh, thank you.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors. All this time out in the freak show when shit like this didn't matter anymore. And we wrote out a farewell. Without Sarah, I knew that we were leaving everything behind.
What did you do?
Everything that mattered was gone.
Folks here in a lot of pain, Deke. You find his stash. You bring it to me.
To me, Deke.
You do that. We'll see what we can do for you.
Deke, Deke, bro.
And I know what kind of man he is. What he's done.
He done any worse than you? Ricky? How about me?
You're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you. We have to look out for each other. That is all we've got.
You could have saved a few lives.
There was no hope, there was no time, there was no room, okay? There was, we'd already turned on each other by the time the hordes arrived. Let's go!
Hope you're right about your old lady, Deke. You gotta ask yourself, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
Days Gone is just 1 month away, so let's take a peek at some new gameplay.
Okay, good.
Days Gone is set in a harsh and unforgiving world populated by roving bandits and flesh-eating freakers. As bounty hunter Deacon St. John, you'll upgrade your bike, scavenge weaponry, and toss Molotov cocktails, all in a bid to stay one step ahead of certain death. And you'll need all the firepower you can find when you face off with the game's more powerful freakers, like this Breaker. But in Days Gone, your wits might be your greatest weapon. Why take on a heavily guarded enemy encampment when you can lure in a freaker horde and let them handle the dirty work?
We can't wait to see the screens
and videos you share when Days Gone launches on April 26th. Before we go, let's get one more update from the gang at NetherRealm Studios.
Who's next?
I'm next. Hollywood.
Yes! He's going for it! Yes!
Go back to the 90s.
Ooh!
Our future, Liu Kang. It is insane.
Okay, so saying fuck is bad, but showing beheadings,
this is seriously messed up.
So hey, much blood and gore, that's
how about
okay.
We keep this between me, myself, okay. And I.
He's gonna get us killed.
That was easy.
Stunts. You? I got people for that. Poser. Don't move this kick back. Gruesome, watch out for Judas Vice and G Unit.
You better check yourself.
It's official. Series veterans Jax, Kung Lao, and Liu Kang are joining the ever-growing Mortal Kombat 11 lineup. And stay tuned, NetherRealm is promising more updates before launch on April 23rd. Well, that's a wrap on our very first episode of State of Play. This was just the beginning. We'll be back throughout the year to share new announcements, first look trailers, and other updates from the world of PlayStation. See you soon, and thanks for watching.
And that's it, right? Okay, so, I'll just keep it right here. Alrighty. That kind of sucked. For first impressions, this is the first episode. When you say that you're going to skip E3 and then give the announcements that you're going to do like State of Plays, you're going to do episodes. We don't even know how many episodes you're going to do per this year. Are you going to do like at least once per month or once every season? We don't know how this is going to go. But the reception for this is going to be awful. When I clicked on this video, I realized that it was like 75% likes, 25% dislike around there. Maybe it's gonna vary after this, but I'm sorry, that kind of sucked. There's only Blood and Truth looked awesome. Concrete Genie, that looked cool. Days Gone looks cool, but it doesn't show a lot, to be honest. The other trailers showed this one did show a bit more information of how it's going to be, and there's the mechanic of bringing the Freakers to the encampment of the enemy. That sounds awesome, but in terms of a very surprising trailer, not really, but it is a good trailer, though. Mortal Kombat is fun, but that's it. You show so many of these VR games that I honestly don't care of. If people who have the PlayStation VR actually cares about this, good for them. But for me, my God, so much emphasis on that. And again, Blood and Truth is like the only thing I would actually want to play. The Iron Man VR trailer, that's the one you want to show up with, and it just looks, it looks like crap. It looks like something you could play for like 5 minutes and that's it. Eagle Flight looks better than that, to be honest. So that was a shame. With you have the Iron Man license and it doesn't look good. Also, the voice of Tony Stark threw me off. I think that was the same one used for the TV show that's happening now. So I expected more of Robert Downey Jr. or the more deep voice from the 1990s animated series with Iron Man. So yeah, I did not expect that to be Iron Man. So I don't know. I didn't expect the graphics to look amazing, but gameplay looks boring as hell. Ugh. Again, they showed only a little bit, so I guess there would be more, but if that's basically it, just fly around shooting repulsor beams at those objects like that, that seems stupid. Hopefully there is more, though. Hopefully there's like Ultron robots you have to destroy, or maybe it takes some liberties with the movies, fighting off the guys who have the... Shoot, I forgot what it's called. That armor thing, you know, the nano armor that heals them and all that stuff. Man, I haven't seen Iron Man 3 in a while, so I told... Extremists! That's what it was. But that's the thing. I totally forgot what they showed for the VR games already. Besides Five Nights at Freddy's, which doesn't look interesting to me. It just looks bland. Observation looks kind of interesting, though. At first, I thought it's a bit like Alien Isolation. Yeah, Alien Isolation. It seems like that, but it says you are the station, so I'm wondering if it's like a Five Nights at Freddy's kind of thing, and you have to direct the woman. Maybe you are like the HAL 9000 from 2001 Space Odyssey. I don't know. But so far, this state of play was mostly boring. The good stuff is saved for the end. But come on, PlayStation, this is all you could give us? No release date for The Last of Us 2, no information of Final Fantasy 7 remake since Kingdom Hearts 3 is finally finished? Nothing? Or the Ghost of Tsushima? Nothing about that one? You guys say you're not going to be at E3, so what's the point of this video? Again, if you say, unless you're going to do, like, weekly videos, like, oh, this is just the first episode, second episode comes out next week, okay, I'm willing to accept that. Like, okay, first episode's a bit sloppy, but at least we're getting it weekly, so we have more information about these games. But no, we don't know when the next episode's going to be. It could probably be 3 months later, and we'll probably be very disappointed by that one, too. What's in 3 months? That's in June? That's pretty much E3. Are you gonna do a state of play during E3 then? You better make it as good as a Nintendo Direct. Come on. I'm not a big fan of Nintendo Direct, but they did a better job than you guys did. Again, this is your first attempt, so I'll cut you a bit of slack, but if you're gonna copy something, copy it well, you know? Anyway, that's the state of play. See you later, guys.